What's up, folks? Welcome to your third Elasticsearch Kibana and Logstash tutorial for the beginners. This is Atik Hemant. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about how to index the data into Elasticsearch from the MongoDB via Nodejs. So, making query from the Elasticsearch, we need to make sure data has to be present in Elasticsearch. So, where indexing concept come into the picture. So, before indexing into the Elasticsearch, let me explain what is index in Elasticsearch. So an index is like a database in a relational database. It has a mapping which defines the multiple types. Then what is Elasticsearch indexing? Well, I picked up a same diagram whatever we have been discussed in my first tutorial. Here you can see that user interact from the web browser via backend server to the database, and all the data is indexed to Elasticsearch. That means database and the Elasticsearch data has to be in proper sync, right? And from the Elasticsearch, it will be coming to the backend server and backend server to frontend. So now we'll see how to index the data from the database to Elasticsearch. So right now I'm going to use the database of MongoDB, and for indexing the data from MongoDB to Elasticsearch, I'm using the server of Node.js. So let's go and do some hands-on coding. So I have already written the code. So what I'm going to do now, I have the data already present in MongoDB. So I'm indexing all the data into the Elasticsearch. So this is the file of all the configuration related thing. So here you can see that I have defined an Elasticsearch, and my Elasticsearch, I want to create an index which is called company, and this is the configuration of MongoDB, and here I am basically defining the local server and the database name. If I want to connect from the server, I have provided the server IP as well and all those things. So my entry point of the application is app.js. So in the app.js, I have called which is called indexer.js. We'll be going to discuss about that as well. So I'm taking index name, index type, and table name, which is basically coming from the Elasticsearch indices company.index, which is nothing but this file. And a config is basically used to take the data from the default.json. It's a basically package. And after that, I'll be calling indexer dot of index MongoDB data, which is nothing but my indexer.js file. So here you can see that indexer.js I am defining in an indexer, and indexer.index MongoDB data. So index MongoDB data, if you go here, if you search, so you can see that this is the function of index MongoDB data. This function I am basically calling. Alright, and after that I am sending the data of index name, index type, and the table name. So table name is basically Elasticsearch company and collection name, right? So what I'm going to do now, I basically run the application of app.js. So first I have to run my MongoDB locally, and I'll say MongoDB. So looks like my MongoDB is running. So let me connect the MongoDB, right? So I'm going to dump the collection of MongoDB tutorial, which is this one, and the collection of company. Let me check the count first. So I have a 10,000 of record. All right. So we need to start the Elasticsearch as well. For start the Elasticsearch, we have to download the Elasticsearch first. So I have already downloaded, and it has been present in my desktop location. So it has present in ELK Stack. So you can see that Elasticsearch has been present as well. So I have to do cd Elasticsearch 7.3.0 bin then I have to say dot slash Elasticsearch. Alright, so looks like it has been loaded as well. So let me go to the browser and let me open the Elasticsearch head. So looks like my Elasticsearch head has already connected. You can see that cluster health is green. So this is nothing but once you have installed your Kibana and this all the indices, it will come automatically to your Elasticsearch. What happens, Elasticsearch sync with the Kibana and Elasticsearch get all the Kibana's data into the Elasticsearch indices. So you don't have to worry about all those indices. Alright, so I'll do one thing right now. So I'll basically go and execute the app.js and to see how the output is basically looks like. So node app.js. Alright. So you can see that I have successfully connected with my MongoDB and each and every time I am basically importing the data into the Elasticsearch, which is 1000. So once the 1000 data has been imported, it has imported next 1000, then next 1000. So like that way I have successfully imported a 10,000 records to my Elasticsearch. So once I have done that, after that I am getting the message of all the data successfully imported into the Elasticsearch, right? So we'll go to the Elasticsearch right now and we'll refresh it, right? Looks like we have already imported all the company data from the MongoDB to Elasticsearch, right? For the better view, what we can say, we can do show me 250 record. So you can see that we have all the records has been indexed as well, right? So for deleting the indices from the Elasticsearch, what you can do, you can directly come here, you can click on delete and you can type delete, delete, and you can click on OK. Or else what you can do, you can go to the app.js. So this is, you can see that inserting the bulk data into the Elasticsearch Kibana from MongoDB. So we don't need that, we have already done that. So deleting the bulk data from the Elasticsearch Kibana from the MongoDB. So we need to execute these lines of code. So again, the concept is also same. So delete mapping I have already defined, we have a function here itself. So it has taken the index name and whatever the index name I have to pass. So this is the index name, so company.index, which is coming from your default.json, which is company.index, right? So your index is nothing but your this index name, right? So what I'm going to do now, I'm clear the screen and I'll run the node app.js once again. So you can see that indices has been deleted, which is company, right? So I'm basically printing here itself, which is company. Then I'll open my Elasticsearch head, I'll make it refresh. You can see that the database of company is gone. All right, in this tutorial we have learned about indexing a bulk data into Elasticsearch from the MongoDB and deleting the bulk data from Elasticsearch. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed this playlist. I am putting all my codes into my GitHub repository. You can find the link from the description box below. I am gonna see you in the next tutorial where we will discuss about more into Elasticsearch and Kibana. Thank you guys. I got broads in Atlanta, just to be in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van, legacies.